This episode's about balls. Hey, Shady Ballers, Jules here for DNews. If you've ever been to Los Angeles, you might have seen a ton of little plastic balls floating on top of their water reservoirs. There are millions of them, so many that from far away, they look more like a blacktop than a giant wet Chuck E. Cheese ball pit. But before diving in face first, consider that these balls actually serve a very important purpose. Reservoirs like the one in Los Angeles store the city's drinkable and potable water, but federal law says that they can't just leave this water exposed to the open air. When the EPA enacted this mandate in 2006, it was responding to an outbreak of cryptosporidiosis, a stomach illness contracted from drinking contaminated water, namely from reservoirs. Cryptosporidiosis is not the only side effect of exposed reservoirs. Uncovered water can be pooped in by birds or just get dirty from dust and dirt settling on top. In the aftermath of 9/11, a lot of people were concerned that open reservoirs would be targeted by terrorists, like the enemy would fly by on a plane and drop in toxic chemicals, infecting entire populations. But Batman-based terror attacks aside, the biggest concern when it came to exposed drinking water, at least for LA County, was a chemical reaction that occurs when water interacts with sunlight. LA's reservoirs contain a small amount of chlorine as a disinfectant. In direct sunlight, when chlorine combines with a natural element found in groundwater called bromide, it creates a chemical called bromate. Bromate sucks to ingest and can cause stomach pain, nausea, and in high doses, serious damage to the kidneys and nervous system. Sunlight can also lead to algae growth, which isn't harmful in itself, but when algae breaks down and the organic components mix with chlorine, it creates byproducts, which have been associated with birth defects and even certain cancers. So, LA County needed to cover up the reservoirs, and they considered a few ways of doing it. The most logical solutions were to build a huge roof or to use a massive tarp, but these alternatives were really, really expensive, like $300 million expensive. That's like 3/4 of the average cost to launch a damn space shuttle. So instead, LA County went with shade balls. The idea was pretty simple. 96 million 4-inch diameter plastic balls would float on the reservoir, preventing evaporation and protecting the water from harmful airborne pollutants and the sun. The balls were also coated with a black carbon colorant that repels ultraviolet light, which can cause plastics and other materials to degrade. This chemical coating is intended to protect them for up to 25 years. Thankfully, shade balls are also economical. Each ball costs just 36 cents, representing a total savings of roughly $250 million for LA County. This is all fairly new. In fact, LA is the first county to use shade balls for this purpose. And they're getting a lot of attention, especially as a way to mitigate the effects of this crisis-like drought. The Los Angeles Reservoir's shade balls are expected to prevent roughly 300 million gallons of water from evaporating every year. So we need reservoirs because everyone needs drinking water. But what if all the water in the world ran out? Can that happen? Find out in this video by Julia.
Some aquifers can take anywhere from 500 to 1,300 years to refill. So it's a pretty large problem. Even the UN said that the world could suffer a 40% shortage of water just 15 short years from now.
So what do you think? Are shade balls really the future of environmental protection? Let us know down below in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe to DNews for more videos every single day.